And now we'll go with the varector diode here also. Okay, the next point or next topic is varector diode. So what is varector diode? Okay, so varector diode is nothing but it can be operated in the reverse bias condition. First point is it can be operated in the reverse bias condition. Whenever the reverse bias is there, so automatically if you increases more amount of reverse bias voltage, the depletion region will be extend. Therefore, the depletion region will be extend. Here, p-type will be considered as one electrode and n-type will be considered as another electrode. Between those two plates, we have more amount of depletion region. That is nothing but it will increases the distance between the parallel plates. A capacitor can be formed by taking two parallel plates. In between the dielectric medium will be there, and capacitance of that capacitor is depends on what the distance between the two plates. Here in our varector diode, it consists of a p-type material, n-type material. In between that, the dielectric material will be, dielectric material is nothing but the depletion region. As we increase the reverse bias voltage, what happens? The depletion region will be increased. Okay, so the depletion region increases means the distance between the plates is increasing. So the capacitance will be varies. Okay, so like this, depending on the requirement of the capacitance or frequency, what we are going to generate, so we can change that capacitance value by using the applied reverse bias voltage. Okay, by using applied reverse bias voltage, by varying applied reverse bias voltage. So by varying reverse bias voltage, we are going to vary the capacitance of the diode. So automatically, that's why it is called as varector, variable capacitor diode. Okay, actual name is varector diode, means variable capacitor. Okay, so that's what the point you can observe. So we'll go one by one. What is varector diode? Varector diode is a kind of semiconductor microwave solid state device. The diodes are chosen for giving the desired capacitance changes, as they are special purpose or special types of the diode. I already told that we can change the capacitance by changing the reverse bias voltage. I will give its equation also. Varector diode is a p-junction diode that changes its capacitance and the series resistance as the reverse bias voltage applied to the diode is varies. Okay, this property of capacitance changes is utilized to achieve a change in the frequency and or the phase of an electrical circuit. Okay, so you already know that we are going to use in LC circuits, tank circuits, the capacitance. Okay, if you use the capacitance, if you want to change that variable capacitance, means automatically you can use a varector diode there, and we can, if you vary with the reverse bias voltage, automatically the capacitance value we can change. Okay, the property of capacitance change is utilized to achieve a change in the frequency and or the phase of an electrical circuit. Okay, so that is what the point. Varector diodes are manufactured with the gallium arsenide. Okay, and it has higher operating frequency. Solid state device or microwave solid state device. So microwave means it has to produce high amount of frequency. Okay, normal audio frequency or video frequency is different, but here it is a microwave solid state device we will consider. Okay, you can learn this one in the microwave subject, but here for us it is considered as a microwave device, and it has very high amount of frequency range. Okay, so varector diodes are manufactured with gallium arsenide, and gallium arsenide has a higher operating frequency up to nearly 1000 gigahertz. It is very, very high frequency. Okay, so here I have mentioned that varector diode is also called as variable capacitance diode, varicap. We called as it as varicap, CAP cap. Okay, so variable, from that one, vary, and CAP cap, varicap diode, or voltage variable capacitor, that is nothing but VCC. Okay, so diode or tuning diode, or why it is called as tuning diode? Because by using this varector diode in the circuits, we can vary the capacitance. The capacitance is varies means automatically the frequency varies. So that's why it is called as, we can tune for the required frequency. That is nothing but tuning diode. That's why it is called as what? Tuning diode, or variable reactance. Also we can have, this has many names, that is variable capacitor, that is varicap, diode or voltage variable capacitor diode or tuning diode or variable reactance. Okay, so this is the introduction for variable capacitor. Then what is the symbol for this varector diode? The symbol for varector diode, it is similar to the what we called the PN junction diode, but another parallel plates indication is given here that represents the capacitance symbol. Okay, so these vertical lines, these two parallel lines will indicate the capacitance. Okay, the symbol of the varector diode looks like common PN junction diode. It includes two terminals, namely cathode and anode. At the one end, this diode is inbuilt with two lines that specifies the capacitor symbol. So that's what this symbol indicates, the capacitor symbol, and at the same time PN junction diode symbol, anode and cathode. Okay, so this is the symbol of varector diode. Okay, so now we'll go how it will works. Okay, what I told, the capacitance will varies with the capacitance will varies with applied reverse bias voltage. Whenever you are using a low reverse bias voltage, what happened here, the depletion region will be very less. So if I increases, why it is very less? Because there is no more attractive forces that are attracts the holes and electrons here in the p-type and n-type. Therefore, there is no movement of holes and electrons, more number of holes and electrons from the junction towards the terminals. But here, if you increases that, what happened here? High reverse bias voltage. If I increases the reverse bias voltage, and we will get a small capacitance. Why it will get a small capacitance? I will give with the equation. Because as I increases, as I increases this reverse bias voltage, what happened here? Whatever the holes, majority carriers that are present will attract it towards the negative terminal, and electrons that are attracted towards the positive terminal. Therefore, only immobile ions will be present. You can observe from this point how it will be. Here, the depletion region is very small, narrow depletion region is present. That is low reverse bias voltage. Here, high depletion region is present. That is the wide depletion region. So therefore, what happened here, if you consider p-type and n-type are two parallel plates, in between that we have depletion region as dielectric medium. So the width of the depletion region or the distance between the p-type and n-type is increasing here. So we know that the capacitance is nothing but epsilon A by D. Okay, epsilon A by W, or we can consider the epsilon A by D here. Depletion width we are taking, that's why I am taking here epsilon A by W. W is nothing but the distance between the two parallel plates. Okay, generally capacitance equation is what? C is equal to epsilon A by D, where D is the distance between the plates. So here, the distance here is nothing but between the plates. If you consider a p-type and n-type are two electrodes or parallel plates, in between that, the distance between them is nothing but the width of the depletion region. So if it increases epsilon A by D, so the denominator is increasing, so automatically the total value of the capacitance will be decreases. So you can observe here how the graph will be obtained. So the capacitance I have taken is in picofarads on y-axis, and reverse bias voltage I am taken on x-axis. If you observe this at zero reverse bias voltage, the capacitance is very max, capacitance is more, because the depletion region width is very less. Okay, so here if you observe the depletion region width is very less, because of that epsilon A by W width is very less, so the capacitance value will be very high. Suppose if you want to decrease the capacitance value, what you have to do is you have to increase the reverse bias voltage. If you increase the reverse bias voltage, what happened? The depletion width will be increases. So if the depletion width increases, according to our formula, that is CT is equal to epsilon A by W. So width increases means automatically CT will be decreases. That's what I have shown in this diagram also. So here it is capacitance in picofarads, and it is reverse bias voltage VR. Okay. So as reverse bias voltage increases, you can observe the red color line graph, that is decreases. The capacitance is decreases. That's what here the operation will take place with the working of a varector diode. Okay. So you can, in case of varector diode, it is possible to increase or decrease the width of the depletion region by changing the level of the reverse bias. This affects the changing the distance between the plates of the capacitor. By changing the reverse bias of the diode, capacitance can change. Okay, that is the conclusion. So you can observe what I have explained. Ct is equal to epsilon A by W. So as I increases, what happened here? As I increases, the depletion width will be increased. As I increases, the depletion width will be increased. Depletion width increases means Ct will be decreased. Okay. So the characteristics of varactor plotted between capacitance and reverse bias voltage. As the capacitance in reverse bias, here W is the width of the depletion region. Okay. As the reverse bias voltage increases, W increases. Okay. That is W is nothing but width of the depletion. Clearly, I have shown here how the variation of the depletion region will be takes place here and here, right? So that is what we have varactor diode operation, okay? And how it will varies with respect to the formula also I have given here, okay? So here, what are the features of varactor diode? Have the following. The features of varactor diode. These diodes significantly generate less noise compared to the other diodes. That is one point. The cost of these diodes available at lower and more reliable also. These diodes are very small in size and very lightweight, and these are not useful when it is operated in forward bias, but in operation reverse bias, varactor diode enhances the capacitance. It will change the capacitance. So there is no useful. If I operate our LED in reverse bias, is there any useful thing? There is no useful thing. Okay, because it can be operated in forward bias and the recombination will take place and light will emit. Similarly, here also, in forward bias, if you operate the varactor diode, it is waste of, it cannot be useful for anything. Okay, but if you apply in reverse bias, if you operate in reverse bias, the varactor diode enhance the capacitance. Okay, so that is the varactor diode property. And it has also, we have different applications. It can be used in main radio frequency. Radio frequency means microwave frequency and radio frequency. That is because at the starting point also I told that it is a micro wave solid state device. So these are all called electronic device, also called as solid state device. Out of that, this varactor diode is microwave solid state. Microwave means it has high frequency. The requirements are high frequency. Similarly, here also we are going to use the applications of varactor diodes are confined to only higher frequency applications we can have. Okay, so the applications of varactor diode mainly involves within the RF design, radio frequency. Radio frequency means very high frequency. Design arena capacitor in a practical circuit can be changed with the varactor diode. The capacitance in practical circuit can be changed with the varactor diode. So it has different applications. You can observe everywhere in the every application, the C will be involved and that C will be of varactor diode. C will be varies by using varactor diode. It can be used as a frequency modulators. Can be used in frequency modulators and RF phase shifters. And next, RF phase shifters means radio frequency phase shifter. Phase is nothing but it involves frequency. Okay. So next one is it can be used as frequency multipliers in microwave receivers, high frequency applications, all those things. These diodes are used to change the capacitance in a tank circuit. LC circuit is called as what? Tank circuit. In that one, L is the inductance and C is the capacitance. Okay. So the C value we can vary by using this varactor diode. C here is nothing but the varactor diode or varactor reactor in microwave circuit. It is used in variable resonant LC circuit. If you vary, generally LC circuit is used to generate a frequency. Okay, tank circuits are used to generate a frequency. Here, if you want to change the frequency automatically, if you change the capacitance value, automatically it will change the frequency generated by the tank circuit. C part is a varied using varactor diode. Okay, next one, it is used in automatic frequency control. Okay, it is used in automatic frequency control. Next, it is used as a frequency modulator in radio and televisions. Okay, in previous, if you observe previous radio system, that is analog radio system, so there will be one knob will be there. Okay, that knob is what here, that will changes the frequency, that will tune the required frequency if you vary with that. Okay, so in that also we are going to use, it is used as a frequency modulator in radios. Okay, and television, we are to tune to the required amount of frequency, required channel. So we are going to tune by using that frequency modulator here. Okay, like this, we have, it is used in voltage controlled oscillator. Okay, these are voltage controlled oscillators are nothing but receivers. In the receivers of analog communication, we are going to use. Okay, next one is, it is used in RF filters. It is used in choosing the right tuning. Okay, it is used in choosing the right tuning. What I told, it can be used in the right tuning.